Hello friends, I hope you like my second video, that is about what is GMP 5 guidelines. If you are having any question, you can ask me in the comment. So in this video, we will discuss about the lifecycle approach to validate a system. So the content reference I have taken from the ISP guideline, that is good practice guide for a risk-based approach to GxP compliant laboratory computerized system, that is second edition. Friends, my YouTube channel name is Pharma Quality. So please like and subscribe my channel to get the knowledge about the pharma quality standards and practices. So let's start. When you procure any computerized system, you must follow the lifecycle approach to validate that system in a compliant manner. So lifecycle activities should be scaled according to system impact on patient safety, product quality and data integrity. So always keep in mind that you are validating the system that will be going to use for some material testing or product analysis, and ultimately it will impact on product quality and patient safety and also the data generated from the system. So it is very important to that data generated from that system should be accurate and reliable. Second is the lifecycle activity should be scaled according to system complexity and novelty. So procured system may have the simple or complex in nature and will be commercially available or newly launched in the market. So basically based on the complexity, you need to validate your system. Third is lifecycle activity should be scaled according to outcome of supplier assessment. That is, while validating your system, you can review the vendor document and leverage the appropriately validated part from the vendor document. So basically saves you time and avoid the perform that test in the duplicate manner. The lifecycle approach of computer system are include four major phases. So first is concept phase. In this phase, you evaluate the requirement of computerized system based on business needs. Second is project phase. In this phase, we validate the computerized system, and after validation, system will release for routine use. So third is operation phase. In this phase, we perform the analysis and testing of material and product as per our standard testing procedure. So the next is fourth and last phase, that is retirement phase. In this phase, we can retire the system if the system is no longer required or that system may go for any updation. So in this slide, we will discuss about specification and verification approach. Often it is called the V model. This is actually a general approach to achieve a compliance and fitness for intended use. So firstly, the system built and configured by manufacturer. So you can see the design of this system includes the user requirement specification, functional design specification and detailed design specification. So after procurement of the system, we perform the installation qualification as per the system design specification. And after completion of installation qualification, we perform the operation qualification that must meet the requirement of functional design specification. Further, after completion of operation qualification, we perform the performance qualification as per the user requirement specification. Performing the installation, operation and performance qualification reflect the quality approach to validate a system. So during validation of system, the identified risks shall be managed by the QRM approach. So next approach is computerized system validation framework. So while validating the system, quality risk management should be the central approach to focus the effort on the laboratory computerized system and functions, where failure would have the highest risk to patient safety, product quality and data integrity. And the QRM approach will vary depending upon the system criticality, complexity and novelty. For example, during the validation, if you have identified any test that is failed against the acceptance criteria, then you must investigate the root cause of failure occurred and accordingly take the corrective and preventive action to mitigate that risk, and finally that risk must be at acceptance level. This is all about the lifecycle approach as per the ISP guideline, and in the next video we will discuss about the lifecycle phases to validate a system. I hope this video will help to better understand that what is lifecycle approach to validate the system. Please do comment to provide your suggestions so that I can improve and deliver good contents. Thank you.